Have you ever wondered if minoxidil will help you grow a thicker beard? I know I have. And in this video, we're going to cover what is minoxidil, will it actually help you grow a better beard, and if so, is it safe to use on your face? My name is Nick Carnese. I'm the founder of Stubble & Sash, and I'm actually really excited to do this video today. So let's just jump right into it. First off, what is minoxidil? Minoxidil is an FDA-approved over-the-counter drug that's used to treat certain types of baldness in both men and women. Now, it's important to note that when you stop treatment, that scalp hair falls out. So if you're balding, you start using minoxidil, the hair grows back in, life is good. If you stop treatment, that hair is gonna eventually fall out. So the treatment is not permanent. You have to keep using it so long as you want that hair. Second item to point out is that minoxidil does not cause your body to create new hair follicles. What it does do, it does stimulate dormant hair follicles, but it doesn't cause your body to generate new hair follicles. So if you don't already have hair follicles under the skin, nothing is going to grow there. So minoxidil stimulates dormant hair follicles, but it does not cause your body to create new hair follicles. Now, can minoxidil promote beard growth? There is a study out of Japan that says, yes, minoxidil is effective at stimulating beard growth, but. Now, before we get into that but, if you're finding value in this video, go ahead and smash the like button. And we'll keep content coming your way. If you ever want us to make any other videos, go ahead and shoot us an email and we'll add those topics into the hopper. All right, going back to the study, what did it find? It found that guys using minoxidil compared to a control group that were using a placebo, the minoxidil group actually did have an increase in the number of hair follicle or beard hairs on their face. There was no increase in diameter though. So minoxidil caused more whiskers to appear, but they weren't any thicker. Additionally, those were actually vellus hairs. The study found that it stimulated some dormant hair follicles that started growing, and these are vellus hairs. But interestingly, those vellus hairs came in longer and darker than the standard peach fuzz that we all know and love. So now the question becomes, if you stop taking minoxidil, will you lose those gains? And I don't know about you, but I've gone down through some YouTube spirals and also on Reddit, and there are a lot of guys that started using minoxidil and they claim that their gains were permanent. And minoxidil does not cause permanent gains. The only way that you can transition a vellus hair to a terminal hair is through hormones. And if you're interested in the beard growing cycle, we'll go ahead and link to it down below, and also have a little flyout out there so you can click on it. But your body starts producing hormones around puberty that start flipping the switch to transition vellus hairs to terminal hairs. Now, it doesn't all happen at once. It doesn't happen over the course of 1 year, 2 years, 3 years. Actually, men, your beards continue to improve up until your mid-30s. That's how long it can take for all of your vellus hairs to transition over to terminal hairs. So the guys that treat with minoxidil and they use it for a number of months or maybe a year or more that have permanent lasting gains after they stop taking it, it's not that minoxidil caused those vellus hairs to transition over to terminal hairs, it's that time. So that year, had they not been taking the minoxidil, those vellus hairs still would have transitioned over to terminal hairs. So that's where it gets kind of sticky, because some guys get a little bummed out, they start using minoxidil, their beards grow in, they start noticing more hair in their beards, they stop taking it, and those gains go away. And the reason why that is because those vellus hairs haven't had enough time for the hormones to naturally transition them over from vellus to terminal hairs. So now the question is it safe to use on your beard or your facial hair? So according to the study, it is safe. Now, minoxidil does have some well-documented side effects. Most of them are very minor. One of the primary side effects is drying and flaky skin. And that's easily solved with a proper facial moisturizer. Fortunately for you, that's what started this whole company. We have a beard-friendly moisturizer that's designed specifically for guys for facial hair, but that's an easy side effect to overcome. Now, it is important to note before you start any drug therapy that you should consult with your healthcare provider, because you might have an underlying condition or you might be on another prescription drug that could have an adverse interaction with minoxidil. So it's always important to consult a healthcare professional before you start any new drug treatment. Should you use minoxidil to enhance your beard growth? That's really a question only you can answer, but I do recommend guys that are under the age of 20, don't rush it. You know, you still have a lot of years ahead of you for that beard to transition over. And while you could start using minoxidil and you could notice some more hair coming in, those gains aren't going to be permanent, right? So give it time. And also understand that you might have to be taking it for much longer than you anticipate. And of course, there is a cost associated with that. Fortunately, the price of minoxidil has gone down over the years. It's just one more thing to factor in as you consider whether or not this is a route you want to go. Now, if you have any questions, comments, please go ahead and drop them below. And we'll see you on the next one.